as I was driving along, like, there was this, like, projective... I don't even know what it was. I don't know how it happened. But as I was driving, I just had this orange hue just come down over my my vision, just like this. And I was like, ooh, this is a bit weird. What's happening? Like, am I really tired? Like, is this real? Then as the song kind of progressed, like, the orange hue became, like, kind of more yellow and more kind of, like, pinky. Like, it had this almost like a sunset. It gets me every time. It's like, I don't even know. It's like literally like grey. Like it's just like a. It's weird because it has like it's like that. Then it has this like strange like arrow thing that like comes down off the top. It's really weird. But it literally just like explodes out. It's like it's mad. Hey, I'm Jake. I'm a practicing artist with synaesthesia. But synaesthesia for me is a joint sensory perception in which I experience sound and noise and music and anything that has a slight kind of vibration to it that is a stimulus as colour and texture. So say you can hear cars going past outside, like I know that, for example, is like a mauvey green colour, like it's got this kind of like gravelly, like rough, slow moving sound. It's how I think about music, because I don't think about music as just an audio stimulus. I think of it as this thing that has both elements. It's audio visual. So yeah, it's just kind of the way I experience things, I guess. The Fibonacci sequence became really kind of important in me writing my paintings as music, because as a way to read music, it gave like a sequential form to it. So this particular piece, because it's transcribed from really, really heavy stuff. It goes from like round here and then up and round and kind of always forms into this kind of spiral in the middle. But all around this area here is kind of like mid to high A minor with like kind of like accidental notes in it. So these little kind of drop notes here. You get the F in there, which is this here, which then falls down into E minor, which is here. I'll do it in one take, like I don't really edit it as such. I just kind of go and do it in one take, and I feel like that's how it should be. And then if it changes very slightly, that's fine. Yeah, so I discovered that I had chromesthesia at Reading Festival in 2012, I think it was. So not that long ago. Like, it's been a fairly kind of recent thing that I've been like, oh, I can work with this. This is what's going to spur my art on. Like, so yeah, I was at Reading Festival, seeing my favourite artist, City in Colour, with my best friend, and we were talking about it. Like, we were just kind of standing back, like enjoying the show, and I just kind of glanced over and I said, oh, this is really like yellow and pink. And she looked at me and she's like, what? she looks over and she's like, no, it tastes like this. And I was like, what are you talking about? Like, well, that doesn't make any sense. Yeah, we had a conversation for a bit, and turns out she has a type of synaesthesia called lexical gustatory synaesthesia, which is basically sound triggers a sensory perception of taste. She was experiencing it like that. I was experiencing it in like color and texture. And then from that point, we kind of were like, oh, okay, that's a little bit strange. Is that not how things work?
And it made me understand what I was experiencing a little bit more, and it made me think, oh, well, this isn't the norm. This isn't how people kind of experience the world, but that's cool, that's all right. It means I can like push myself and like create something more.
If I can read it, if I can understand it as colour, and I can read music, why can't I then transcribe that onto a canvas and then play it as a piece of music? So in order to show you guys a little bit about how my practice works and how I've kind of developed it, I've been asked to paint a song by the band Flyte called Faithless. I've never heard it before, don't really know what to expect. This is a complete surprise. So what I'll be painting is my initial first reaction to the song, and this is it. So the majority of the pieces that are on display in the house and that I've just shown you, I've created literally out the back of the, like in the garden. The garden here is really open and it just creates an environment where I can go out there and I can put my headphones in and just be completely free and I can move around. I spoke about like my work almost becoming a performance sometimes, and that I need quite a lot of space to do that, so I really enjoy working outside. Okay, so just listening to the song for the first time. Gonna use quite a lot of paint, I've realised, because there's quite a lot of layers. Listening to it on headphones afterwards made me realise there's a lot of depth in the actual song itself. It's literally like a bluey green, like kind of, I don't know, because there's like a low end bit that's kind of like a deeper, like darker blue, and it kind of moves up and down. This is gonna get quite messy, and I'm quite looking forward to it. Escape from the crowd as you walk down the street. And how does it feel to no longer belong, to be so far out? When that guitar part comes in, it has this like almost fluorescent purple that cuts through. It's like I can't describe it. I can only describe it like by putting it down on canvas. So through this line here, it's gonna be like a line of sound, and that will be hopefully the guitar solo part. This is probably about 3 or 4 marks away from being completed. It came together really quickly in the end. I started experimenting with the textures on the canvas. These marks here is just a bass frequency that's running through it. So I wanted to keep some kind of order to the chaos that's happening here. And done. This is how I perceive certain parts of the song Faithless, and yeah, I really like it. I really like the song. It was really fun to paint. Bass tends to be quite murky and kind of like a slow moving, kind of thick, kind of viscous like kind of paint, whereas treble, it splits itself apart and it cuts through and it has like, it's jagged and pointed. And then when you get like kind of medium tones in the middle, that's where you get the long strokes. So this is Faithless. This is how I see it. I'm gonna build together a projection sequence, gonna show the band, and hopefully they like it. Yeah. So yeah, what I usually do is frame the initial piece with one photograph. That's usually what I work from, but with this piece, because there's so much texture in it, I want to individually photograph certain bits and then work into it from there. I'll have kind of more to play around with, and then hopefully when the sequence is then built,
I'd be able to put it together as a cohesive piece.
So with chromesthesia, there are two main types of it. Most people that have chromesthesia will have one or the other. Like, it doesn't often overlap, but there's associative synaesthesia, which is the majority of the time what mine is, where you'll hear a sound, you'll hear a voice, a note, a piece of music, and you'll just automatically know that it's that color. Like, it just something is like that. It's like, oh, it's red, blue, like, and it exists in your mind in the same way that a memory does. Like, it's there, you can't see it, but you know that it's there, and you have this kind of like subconscious experience of that color. And then projective synesthesia is kind of the same thing, but like it comes into your field of vision essentially. So you'll have like almost like a cloud, or things will start distorting like a little bit, and you'll have like colors coming in and seeping into your vision like really slowly and like sometimes really fast. It depends what the actual sound stimulus is.
Flyte. I think everyone sort of wants to claim that it's like, yeah, I can see colours when I, you know, but it's obvious that some people, they have that actual gift. Yeah, because I think we were thinking along the lines of colour and interpreting colour actually as we were making the music itself. Especially when composing a record, it's like which song is yellow, which song is red, which is, you know. So when we heard about you making, you know, colour out of our music, we're really interested to see how, you know, someone else would interpret that.
Abstract.
So is it different parts of the song in different areas?
Yeah. I tried to kind of like do it in steps. So like this start here is the kind of like the piano run right at the start, and then I'll kind of come down and round as the song progresses. Like, and then these parts here is like, this is the chorus coming through, like these parts up here are. Like I said about the kind of like visual crescendo.
So you've got the blues and the kind of tranquil colours for the verse, and then the kind of reds and the more dramatic colour for the chorus, that makes sense. Yeah. And the reverse guitar solo.
Yeah. Right there. Yeah.
All right, nice.
Yeah. So the projection work kind of is then to create like a synthesized synesthesia for the audience. So it kind of takes how I experience it, put down onto canvas, and then kind of explode it back out into the world, and then project into whatever environment it possibly can. And I'll be there when the clip you Okay, so we've just seen Flyte live. They were absolutely amazing. Their voices live are just, words cannot comprehend how good they are. They performed Faithless at the end in the middle of the crowd acoustically, and it was just so different to what I painted, like how I interpreted it last time. It was more kind of orangey, like pink. His voice still cut through as the turquoise pinky tones, but like the overall kind of feel of the song was completely different. They were amazing. That was a really nice way to end this whole thing. Just wow.
I guess like if I think about it, it helps me enjoy music even more. Like music and art are like, they are my life. Like that's what I've done my entire life. That's all I want to do with my life. And one thing can help the other and they are completely synchronous with one another, yeah, I think it's definitely a blessing. Flick or switch.